Particularly important is that we're observing an increase on daily use of marijuana across all of the school grades, 8, 10th, and 12th. And these increases go between 10 to 18%, so they are very large for a one-year period. They're problematic because daily marijuana use is the one that leads to greater pathology, and it could be estimated that between 25 and 50% of these daily marijuana using kids are likely to be dependent on the drug. And what we know, for example, from epidemiological studies is that those kids that start taking marijuana before age 17 are much more likely to become dependent not just on marijuana, but on a wide variety of different drugs. So observing these significant increases in the eighth graders is actually quite worrisome. So the question is, do we want a nation of kids that are using marijuana and getting mellow and interfering with their ability to study and perform? Or do we want to have kids really engaged on activities and excited and driven? And to me, that's a crucial issue for us, because our nation, of course, relies on its new generation to build itself up into the future. But where we're observing now that marijuana is going up, whereas cigarette smoking, though it has not continued to go down, it's stabilized, is that if you look at an indicator of past month use, there are more marijuana cigarette smokers in 12th grade than nicotine cigarette smokers. Unfortunately, this year on the survey, we're seeing a significant increase in the use of ecstasy in 8th and 10th graders, which may reflect, we believe, the lack of attention on this drug, since we have been, I guess, become complacent by the fact that the rate of use of these drugs have gone down very, very dramatically. The fact that we're seeing it rising again highlights the importance of prevention campaigns that do not ignore this particular type of drug. For the first time, we're seeing this year a significant decrease in the past year use of Vicodin, which is a pain medication, among 12th graders. Unfortunately, the rest of the indicators remain very high, like OxyContin over 5%, amphetamine over 7%, and Adderall over 5%. So all of those are very, very high rates of abuse of psychotherapeutics.